All right, thank you. Our Hog Wild special continues with a story about the Razorback's name. Now, several high schools across the country call themselves the Razorbacks, including one just across the border in Oklahoma. Our 4029 reporter Jonathan Rosell has the story about how they got their name.
Welcome to Panama, Oklahoma, home of the Razorbacks. But just how did the school district get its name? Well, it depends on who you ask.
This is speculation. The first head football coach here at Panama was supposedly a coach from the University of Arkansas. Not saying head coach, just a coach from Arkansas. So he comes over, wants to change the name. That's how we became the Razorbacks.
That would have been in the 1930s, but others say they're not sure.
I've talked to a lot of the old timers around town, and no one can exactly pinpoint the origin of when Panama's sports team became the Razorbacks.
I don't really know. I really don't. I mean, it's been around now. I mean, I'll be 64-year-old in November, and it's always been the Razorbacks to me.
Although they share the same mascot, there are some slight differences. Traditionally, the U of A's hog runs right. Panama's faces left. The U of A's hog has a flat back. Panama's has a humpback,
which is a more aggressive Razorback than a flat Razorback.
And Panama's hog has a green eye.
In the 1900s, this used to be a mining town, and the houses here were painted red. So the grasshoppers was a mascot, so it used to be called the Red Town Grasshoppers. But we do implement the green eye for the grasshoppers into our hog.
I've heard since I've lived in Panama, which is approximately 20 years, that we were named the grasshoppers prior to being the Razorbacks. And the carryover from that is the green eye and the hog.
Some residents doubt that story too, including Simpson.
I've heard a lot of stories of that, and I've heard a few people mention it, but I don't believe we were ever the grasshoppers. I think that's just got started somehow in a coffee shop or something.
Panama School District tells me there is no way to tell which story is true. A lot of their records from then have been lost or were destroyed in a school fire back in the 1960s, where this head start now sits.
I know it definitely is interesting anyway, but I don't know if we'll ever actually find out the true story behind the grasshopper and the green eye.
In Panama, Oklahoma, Jonathan Rosell, 4029 News.